What's up? So, made it to far, got offloaded. It was a little bit of a pain in the butt, but it fired up. I had to squirt a little ether in it, the shop kid did. Then luckily I got some help to line up the gooseneck to the trailer, so all connected, ready to go. But of course, there's another truck in the way right there. I gotta wait until they're out of the way, so I'm stuck here. And I got word from other boat drivers, there's no boats. So the plan is I'm gonna go to the truck stop after. We gotta take this trailer to the tire shop, swap out the spare, then we're gonna drop the trailer off the drop yard, and then we're bobtailing to the truck stop for a shower and some laundry, and just ready to go. All right, so I had to cut that one a little short. The guy was ready to go. He was getting out of the way, and then I backed out of there, got on down the road. I'm now here at the tire shop, waiting on one car to get fixed, finished up, and apparently they're doing construction here. They got a scissor lift in the way, so they're gonna have to move that out of the way. But they're gonna change out the spare tire, and then I'm gonna head over to our yard, drop off the trailer, and bobtail to Flying J, get a shower in, and they already said to basically drop the trailer, bobtail to the truck stop. there's no loads, so that's what we're gonna do, and enjoy the rest of the day, I guess. Talk with you later. Well, good morning. It is Tuesday morning. Like I thought, I wouldn't get a load until Tuesday, but luckily I'm getting a load. There were four going outbound already, as me and another guy just now arrived to get our loads. And there are four more sitting out of the gate right now, all waiting
to get
loads.
Turn left on US 281 Northeast Military Highway.
All right, well, we're going to shut that girl off. That is going to drive me crazy here. Mute. And it looks like we are going to go to New York and then Connecticut. I don't know if it's technically Long Island, New York, or just New York, but it is Huntington on Long Island in New York. First delivery. And then we're going to go up to Connecticut. Not too far from the place I delivered roofing material for a bowling alley that was being built or re-roofed, and they sent me all the way out there with the wrong material. That was an interesting run. Pretty cool though. I had nice Italian food across the street. Got to park up in the parking lot there for the overnight. But I had to reload everything in the rain and drive all the way back to I know it's Pennsylvania, but I'm trying to think of the town. Yep, it was for Firestone. Had to $84.81. I am here to get the load, so just typing in everything. I'm backed up to the trailer, time to change my duty status. We are going to go on, we're going to load and doing a pre-trip inspection. So, come on. Trimble's half asleep. It hasn't had its coffee yet. All right, so time to go get this hooked up, connected. And as you can tell, it is rainy. It's drizzly, but the guys and gals are out there in the fields harvesting crops. So this is like the perfect weather for them, other than it's going to get quite muddy. It's great for them to work out in this because beats the alternative, right? Beating sun. And yesterday it was like 90 degrees, so it's going to get humid when the sun does pop out. This place needs water bad. So time to get going. There's already a truck out ready for escort, and then we saw three heading out near the highway anyways, or already. So time for me to get moving and strap down these crates, finish off this load. We'll get you, talk to you guys later when I get on the road. All right, everybody. So, like I like to point out, just enjoy the opportunity when you're out here. Enjoy the life. It's not always going to be great, and it's not always going to be bad. But I met another driver, another TMC driver. His name's Nathan. We picked up at a far at the same time, the only two loads that were available. He told me about this barbecue place. Pretty much it's just before the split of 35W and 35 south of Dallas, so it's like the last opportunity to get really good, kind of like easy place to park and great food. Let me show you. Barbecue. Got a couple slices of bread. I got brisket and sausage under there, and they threw some pickles and onions. I went with the coleslaw and some barbecue beans. So this is exit 353 on Interstate 35. The parking lot is still pretty much empty, but it is kind of plotted out for cars. Even though we got truck accessible fuel pumps. But right through here, it's all marked off for car parks. So I don't know what they had in mind, but we got here. And yes, I got my camping chair out. The weather is great right now. It's overcast. It might actually rain tonight. They were predicting some storms and possible tornado activity in the Dallas area. So I'm gonna keep my eye on the weather, but for right now, it's great. It's just a little dark. Sorry for the lighting, but it's dinner time. 3rd trailer in a row. 3rd tire blowout. I'm in Earl, Arkansas, TA, off of I-40. We are just west of Memphis. We're on our way to Long Island, New York, to Huntington, New York. And it turns out the three boats that I have are going to end up being three deliveries. So the second boat on the trailer, the one in the middle, is now going to be a third stop that they added. It is in Connecticut. can't remember what town I wrote it down, but it's not too far from the final stop in Connecticut, but in Norwalk. But still, apparently, they say everything happens in three as well. I'm done with the tire blowing out, alright? My gosh. And then I get a phone call from my fleet manager telling me he sent me a message yesterday to give him a call real quick. Well, I was in traffic in I think it was Austin. Or no, I was still in San Antonio. And just busy with traffic, stuck in the traffic, so I couldn't give him a call. So by the time I was able to get to a rest area to pull over to make a phone call, it was past 5:30. He was already out of the office and gone. So I kind of figured, well, if it was something really important, they would have called me and tried to get me to answer, which you don't do when you're driving. But kind of gives you a little more of a heads up, finding the next truck stop or something. But that didn't happen, so I just kept on going. That's how I am. I'll roll if it's not that important. And it turns out this morning he does the same thing, but then he goes on to do some training somewhere. So sends me the message to call him. So then I get going down the road. I get the message, and then I go to call him, and he's in training. So it took like most of the day to get through to him. When I finally get through to him, it was just all about, your idle time is high. We gotta just, keep. He goes, I want you to be comfortable and sleep and get your rest, but just keep an eye on your idle. It's high. And I'm like, huh. I kind of laughed. I go, that's kind of funny because I've literally the past week had 334s on that last trip. So how is it high? And he goes, well, it's not really like you're idling all the time. It was just out of his group of drivers, everyone else is like in cold areas, so they're not really idling at all. And I'm in Texas, Arizona, New Mexico, and California. But the only time I really idled was when I was getting loaded with that loader that was a pain in the butt. And it was hot as hell, and I was sweating like crazy. And then I said I didn't idle in Arizona. It was actually pretty cold when I got there, when I slept. I didn't idle in Texas. It was cold. I said the only time, and then I did idle getting offloaded. It was actually cool. Oh, I idled the other night when I had no load. I bobtailed over to the truck stop because we were waiting for a load. And I try not to, like, I got out of the truck and then went to a restaurant and ate dinner. But when I got back to the truck, it was nice at first, but it's like the wind just stopped. It just shifted or something, and then it just got humid. And down there in South Texas, it could get really humid and nasty. And then last night, I tried to sleep without idling, and then I had my the window open, and a truck pulled up next to me, and they started running his APU, and I woke up just coughing off of diesel exhaust because his APU was pumping right at the window. So that's what I told him. I said, well, that's it. He goes, no real big deal. He goes, I just gotta make the phone calls. You know, you're up there out of the percentage of our load of our division. So he goes, on a good note, he goes, you are number two on my fleet. I'm like, well, that's a good note. He goes, you're within like 12 miles of the other number one guy, so of the most miles, getting put down and making money toward the truck. So, I'm like, yeah, well, it's not like I'm really dispatching myself. Just driving. I mean, as long as you put out close to, you know, 11 hours a day, you're going to run out of your clock. Like, I'm going to run out of my clock tomorrow. We're going to try to make it to Virginia. I don't know if I'll make it all the way. Before I do my 34. And because they've added the third stop, I just said, forget it. I'm not even going to try it. I'm going to push this delivery until next Monday, which is when I should be in Brownsburg for a service. And that's just the way it's going to be. I'll be getting service late. I'm not going to be over on miles toward the truck. I should be still good. I'm at 37,000 miles, and you got to do it before 40,000. So I'm good on that end. But their schedule of getting me in is just not going to work. It's the way it is. And he's already talking about getting me another backhaul after this load. So he's already got something planned. Even though I don't have an LRGN, I still have an RGN. So whatever it is has to be put on with a forklift. Unless I'm swapping trailers with someone. Which I heard that he's done that too to another driver yesterday in New York. So we'll see. He's like, I got another... looking at another backhaul for you to head back to Texas. So that's what we'll be doing after our service. So, all right, that's my recap as I'm waiting on a tire to be changed out. I'm not in the shop yet. This is what sucks though too. The truck stop when I got here had plenty of parking in the back. It had some spots open, but I'm not in the shop yet, and I'm going to lose this spot when I pull out. So I can tell drivers are hunting for a spot to park. And so that's why when I first got here, I went in and grabbed something for dinner and like prepared to, if I got to run, I still got 2 hours of drive time. That's more than enough to get me over to West Memphis, but I might end up just going to the next rest area, park on the shoulder somewhere, which sucks because I've seen how it gets, and those rest areas suck. They're bad. I mean, there's garbage everywhere. There's big old potholes on the shoulder. It's not the most ideal section from here to West Memphis, so fingers crossed they swap out the tire and I'm able to get me a spot instantly. All right, John with Green, I'll be rolling. Talk with you later. Well, it's morning. It's not a good morning, it's just morning. I'm irritated. It's going on 3 a.m. And I'm just minutes away of finishing up my 10-hour break where I'd be able to get rolling as long as my tire was fixed. Well, yesterday afternoon, when I didn't want to lose my parking spot, and I was told they could set up an appointment to push out when the tech was able to change out the tire. So that way I didn't have to leave my spot and lose it, and then look like half of these guys looking for a spot later. Well, I just went in there wondering how much longer, since they didn't call me. I was straight lied to. Lady comes to the counter and is like, we don't even have a tech. We won't have a tech until 8 a.m. sorry you were informed, but we don't set up appointments and we don't have a tech. Just one more frustrating thing, when lack of information or communication happens, that can be frustrating. But it happens because not everyone's on the same page. That's where you learn to ask questions, so that way you cover your own self, you know, your own ass. But when someone straight up lies to you, so I'm sitting here drinking my coffee, I'm already halfway done, and then now I'm like, well, you know how difficult it is once you get up, you get your morning routine going, start drinking your coffee, you want to go right back to bed. I want to go right back to bed, but now I'm going to lay there, not able to fall asleep. Then 8 o'clock's going to come, I'm going to go in there, I'm going to raise hell, get this tire changed, and my entire day is just going to be already hours behind, which is going to push my 34 out even more. But the 34, in a way, it's not really going to matter, because they're closed, the boat dealerships are closed on Sunday. I'm going to see if I could get parked up at the first location on Sunday, so that way as soon as I get offloaded the first boat, I gotta go back into New York, get on the 95 and head toward Connecticut. Now the distance really isn't that far. I mean, a good, if you get elevated enough on the first location, I could look across a section of the ocean and from the island to Connecticut and see the other two locations. So it's not the distance, it's the traffic. And there's, from what I could tell about that East Coast, New York, from Maine through New Jersey, I'll just add them all together as one. They got two speeds. About 10 miles an hour over the speed limit, racing like they're running from the cops. Or about 8 miles an hour below the posted speed limit on a Sunday cruise. They don't merge on like they should. It's just frustrating. Just frustrating. The sad thing is, that's trucking. You get the bad with the good. I'm trying to get the glare out of the scene here, and then my neighbor just woke up and I don't want to see his naked body walking around. Guess I'm gonna finish off this cup of coffee. Don't want it to go to waste. Then lay down till 8 a.m. Bye. Update. I am still in the shop. Mechanic did not arrive until 9 a.m. It is 11 a.m. and they are still trying to figure out how to put the tire back on. It took about 15 minutes for them to figure out how to get their jack under the trailer to raise it high enough to take off the wheel. It's almost laughable right now how long it has taken for this crew to just change a tire. Trucking. They said it'd be fun, they said. All right. Yeah, it's 11 a.m. I'm still at the TA. Got a long way to go tonight. It's Thursday, but I still gotta do a 34. John with Green Abbey Rolling. Talk to you later.
Well, made it here to Long Island in Huntington, New York. The actual route isn't that bad. It's just more frustrating with the heavy New York traffic. I did my reset in Virginia, just like 3 miles from the border of Maryland on 81. The weather was great over there. Got to sleep in twice. I knew when I called the dealership, which is, you get the marina right here. Those are all like lights from boats and stuff. The marina is like, I think it's, yeah, that light right there, right here. The dealership is where I'm going. You do go through Huntington town. I don't know if it's called a township, but the roads are narrow. I called ahead and I said, you know, I was like, I'm not gonna be able to make Friday. It's gonna be a Monday delivery. And I left about noon at the truck stop. It's about a 7 hour drive. Depending, it took about 40 minutes just to get across the bridge through New York. That's like LA traffic. It's no joke. It's actually a joke because how bad it is on a Sunday. But yeah, that's the worst of it. The roads, the lanes are super narrow. The road condition is terrible. There are potholes and junk everywhere. And the traffic is nonstop. And it's like, expect cars to cut you off, narrowly hitting you. Even big trucks, they'll know. It's actually the local drivers, the local big truck guys that will cut you off. They don't care. They're just like cutthroat. The other guys, they just know. It's like if they go through there a lot, they know traffic's going to be the way it is. You're going to need to get over. They'll let you over. But right now, the dealership said, basically, I'm in a parking lot at a baseball field. There's baseball fields right here. Someone's working out over there, getting their calories burning off here. So I'm in a parking lot. There's a car over here rocking out to Guns N' Roses. Other than that, once the car leaves and they're done rocking out, it's gonna be pretty peaceful. just hearing geese and geese are flying in right over here, and then air traffic, but for the most part quite peaceful and gonna be nice and cool. Tomorrow's gonna be a little bit frustrating, I know, because gotta get the first boat off, and then they added this as a third drop to Westbrook, Connecticut, and then this one final in Norwalk, Connecticut. I think I've been to this one before. It's the Westbrook one that's going to be actually a possible pain in the butt. That, and I gotta go right back through New York. I gotta go 495, 295, to the 95, up and over the bridge, and then head toward Connecticut. So, even though it's just one boat, sometimes it can be a little bit difficult. It's just time consuming to get it all off. Believe it or not, it's way easier having an oversized. I mean, I was talking to a driver who comes here all the time with the big boys, as he calls them, the big boats. So he comes here, and he was telling me about how tight it is. And yeah, some of the roads were tight. The roundabouts, there's two roundabouts, they were a little tight. But to be honest, I've been in tighter areas. So far, this didn't really throw me a new one. It's just aggravating. I had to get out of the truck and walk around for a little bit, let my blood pressure come down just from New York traffic. That's all it is. New Jersey and New York traffic. Going up and over the GW Bridge. Dealing with just that. It's nice and cool. I'm gonna walk around the parking lot, kind of head that way, stretch the legs, and then try to figure something out on TV. John with Green, I'll be rolling. I'll talk with you guys later. Have a good night. So I thought it was a car rocking out over here, but nope, it's someone that lives on their boat. It's a sailboat right here. Got pretty good stereo going on. Gotta say, I like his choice of music.